Hi everybody, I am your Prasad. Today our topic is program can be stated by, expressed by some ways. First one is algorithm, second one is flowcharts, or our pictorial representation or diagrammatical representation. Next one is pseudocode and last one is with syntax and semantic representation of a program. We'll go one by one. First, algorithm. A program can be expressed by algorithms. What are algorithms? Algorithms are English step-by-step representation of a program. Of a C, C++, Java, any program can be expressed by algorithm. Algorithm means a step-by-step English representation of a program. Flowcharts. Flowcharts means pictorial, diagrammatical representation of a program. In my next video, I will post this. Pseudocode. P is silent here. Pseudocode means how many for loops we are using, how many if conditions we are using. We will mention that in English. Right? Syntax and semantic. Syntax means rules. Semantic means we should not have any spelling mistakes, any grammatical mistakes in our program. Syntax, semantic way we will write the program. For example, for loop syntax. For loop syntax is for initiation, condition and increment or decrement. This is the for loop syntax. In this way we have to write the code, right? We have four ways to express our program. Yeah, the subject is C programming for problem solving, nothing but PPS. Here, as previously I told you, a program can be expressed as flowcharts, algorithms. Your flowcharts basics are with name and shapes and their names. Here, program will start and end indicated with oval shape. The program starting and ending indicated with oval shape. And any process, any variable declaration given is indicated with a rectangle box. And any input-output data is indicated with parallelogram. Parallelogram symbol, shape. Decision, if decision, if condition is indicated with a diamond. If it is true, yes, it will go in this way. If it is no, wrong, it will go in this way. Condition satisfaction. Stored data, extra shapes are this. And the arrow mark will be indicated with connector. These are basics of a flowchart indicated for a program, right? And algorithm. Algorithms are also very simple. It has step-by-step English representation of a program. I already told you. Step 1 will be start generally. And step 2, how many variable declaration will be comes under this. And step 3, some formulas will comes under this. And final step will be stop. Etc. Steps will be there for the program. Right. Yes, algorithm for sum of two numbers. Here we are writing algorithm for sum of two numbers. Same thing we are writing flowchart for sum of two numbers. Here starts from, already told you, algorithm is a step-by-step English representation of a program. The definition of algorithm is English step-by-step representation of a program. That goes something like this. Step 1, generally step 1 will be start. And step 2, already told you, declaration of the variables. Here we are sum of two numbers, so we are taking, declaring variable A and B and storing it into sum. And then step 3, reading those values. If the values are not given, with scanf in a program syntax, but here reading a value in English we are writing. And step 4, adding the two numbers, just like formula. And finally, in step 5, program will be stopped. Same thing will comes here. Flowchart. Flowchart for the sum of two numbers, the program starts with start symbol, oval. Generally it will start with start symbol, oval. Then rectangle, the declaration of the variables. A, B and sum will be declared. Same thing like this. And in parallelogram, we will read the values. We will read A and B values. And same in rectangle, again, sum of two numbers, the formula will be here. Same oval shape, we will stop the program. Same thing. Okay. Algorithm for roots of quadratic equation. Same algorithm already told you. The quadratic equation looks something like this. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Same thing, step 1 obviously will be start generally. And step 2, declaring ABC discriminant, DIC, root 1, root 2. Step 3, calculating discriminant. The formula will be discriminant b square minus 4ac. And if discriminant is greater than or equal to 0, then root 1 formula will be minus b plus root of discriminant means this one by 2a, and R2 minus b minus here minus here plus here minus root of discriminant by 2a, the root 1 root 2, else roots are real and imaginary. Fourth, final step will be stop, obviously. Okay. Yes, algorithm for minimum of 3 numbers. Algorithm for minimum of 3 numbers. This is important question. Generally, step 1 will be start every time. Step 2 will be 3 numbers, no? So, declaring of 3 variables, 3 values. And then step 3, reading those values, taking the numbers for those values, constants. Then in step 4, we have the logic. If A is greater, A is less than B, because minimum, A is less than B, and if A is less than C, display A as small, minimum. Then else, if else, display C is smaller. For example, I will show you. A is less than B. A less than B means we are looking for smaller. So we can cancel bigger number. Then A is less than C and bigger number we are cancelled. So our answer will be A, display A. Otherwise, C is bigger. Otherwise, C is smaller. Then else if B is less than C, B is smaller. If B is smaller, B is smaller. Here, less than. Else, C is smaller. Then final step will be stop. Okay? Yes, algorithm for finding prime number. Here prime number means the number which is divisible by 1 and itself is called a prime number. In step 1, generally program will start. In step 2, declare variable n, I and flag. N is the value which we want to check whether it is prime number or not. I we will divide with this. And flag is the condition to check whether it is prime number or not. Initializing variables, flag will be 1 and I equal to 2 because prime number starts from 2. And step 4, read n from the user, n which we want to check whether it is prime number or not. In step 5, if remainder equal to 0, for example, this is the formula, flag will be 0. For example, you have taken n as 4 or 6, any even number, the flag, the answer will be 0 because we, if you are dividing with 2, it will be, remainder will be 0. So any even number will not be prime number. So if you have taken odd number, if you have taken even number, flag will be 0, the answer will be not a prime number. If you have taken even number, the I will be incremented. I will be incremented with 1 and it will check for this formula and it is a prime number. And final step will be always stop. Thank you.